Now for an update a lot of my subscribers have been asking for, the famous AC smell in the Tesla Model 3. My name is Evan, and if you're new here, welcome. A lot of Tesla owners, including myself, have had to combat the issue of rotten egg smell when they first get into their car. The AC would turn on, and within the first few seconds, the smell would come spewing out of the vents. About 1 minute later, the smell would recede and I would forget all about it. This happened in the summer of 2019 after I reached out to Tesla service regarding the issue. I was told it was not covered under the warranty, unfortunately, and that it would cost about $200-some to clean the coils and replace the cabin filters. I asked the service guy about how I could fix this myself, and he said they used one container of Coolit brand evaporator foam cleaner and that the internal cabin filters are readily available online. After talking through the dismantling process to get to the filters and coils, I was on my merry way to give this a try myself to save $200. Now, I'm a pretty handy guy, and really, it wasn't too difficult at all to do this. I posted the step-by-step process on my first YouTube video back in September 2019. The foam cleaning worked, I posted a second video at the 30-day mark with no issues of any smell returning, until I hit that 60-day mark. Unfortunately, the smell returned. To be fair though, I did not replace the cabin filters just because they did not smell at the time, and overall, they looked fairly clean. In my third video update regarding the AC smell, I again had to clean the evaporator coils, but with this time I used two cans of Coolit, and now with new cabin filters I found on Amazon. And now the smell again was once eliminated. The cleaning was done on November 1st, 2019. I then made another video on a new product by Xtechnor, the internal HEPA cabin filters. On January 31st, 2020, I replaced my regular internal cabin filters with the Xtechnor HEPA filters, but did not clean the coils with the foam cleaner. I had no foul smell coming from the vents, and foam cleaning at the time was not needed. Just to give you a little background on these HEPA filters by Xtechnor, they are a really snug fit and can be a little challenging to install. The reason for this tight fit is so all of the incoming air will go through the filter and not seep through the sides like the traditional cabin filters. Now, I cannot claim the actual filter material itself is HEPA grade, but I can tell you it does smell better than the stock filters. You may have seen in my other videos where there is a large intake hole in the hood of my Model 3. I highly recommend you get a plastic screen or exterior filter to close that gap. This will prevent debris such as leaves and small twigs from entering the vent down to the cabin filter. I currently have this inlet pre-filter by Farmogo and a vent grill by Beaujarvie. It's very important that if you buy one of these pre-filters that it's by the brand name Farmogo. Other inlet filter brands will cause too much airflow restriction, and it will make it very difficult for the Model 3 cabin to cool or heat properly. You can check out my previous video on this right here. I personally like the inlet filter to help mitigate some outside fumes before it goes through the internal cabin HEPA filters. If you would rather not add a pre-filter, an absolute must is adding a vent grill, preventing debris from falling into the internal cabin filters. Again, I found this coverlet grill on Amazon for around $20. The links for all these items I mentioned are in the description below. Now for the answer you all have been waiting for. Has the smell returned since I sprayed two cans of foam cleaner back in November 2019? The answer is kinda yes and kinda no. I recently went on a week-long vacation in July, and the car was left in my garage all during this time frame. I came back to take the car for a drive, and I got a hint of mildew smell for about 10 seconds before it went away. What's funny is, since then, I could not replicate the smell. I use my Tesla Model 3 usually about twice a day, so I'm guessing that the smell was only because I left the car in the garage for about a week without turning the fans on. You may notice now that after you exit your Model 3, the fans may be running for a few minutes. This was in a software update pushed in 2019. I believe it was 2019.12, which will help diminish mildew inside the coils after you leave the car. So to answer your question, after using two containers of Coolit and with the software update, I think the smell has greatly reduced. Again, this will all vary based on your climate. Here in the south with the humidity the way it is, it may be a routine maintenance item to add to your list maybe every 2 years or so. If you live in the north with less humidity, maybe only every 5 years. If you're looking for a step-by-step process to eliminate the smell in your Tesla Model 3, be sure to check out my very first YouTube video under my channel. Now onto the air quality test. I bought this air quality monitor on Amazon just because I got so many requests regarding the Xtechnor HEPA filters and Farmogo pre-inlet filter I had installed earlier. I wanted to see if there is actually deduction of outside fumes when using these products. Depending on your response, I may do a comparison of the regular Tesla cabin filters with this device in the future. Just to quickly show you a contrast from the inside of my house versus outside, we can see the TVOC rating, which means volatile organic compounds, measure how polluted the air is. This could be anything from paint chemicals to plastic products or even woven fabrics. It appears the inside of my house is rated at 5.2, which is surprising to me, but I guess it is true about what they say, how indoor air quality is usually 2 to 5 times more polluted than outdoor air. Now when I walk outside, we can see how much of a difference the air is when I speed the frame up over the course of 3 minutes. I even brought this device to my employer at the office just because I felt the air at my house was terrible. Turns out I do not feel as bad now. The air was polluted so bad inside that the device literally could not read any higher. Anyways, now that I've had my fun with this thing, let's try it out in the Tesla. As we can see here in my garage with the door closed over the course of 2 minutes, it reads about 0.53 TVOC. After getting into the Model 3, it eventually went down to 0.33. So here we go, I closed the doors and the windows and turned on the AC with the airspeed setting of 7 on recirculate mode, meaning the air will stay inside the cabin and go through the internal Xtechnor HEPA filters multiple times with no outside air coming in. I recorded this session for 5 minutes. We can see it drop down to a low of 0.13 and eventually climbs back to 0.16. Again, I do another test with the same process, all doors and windows closed, airspeed at 7, but now I turn off the recirculate mode. We started off at 0.20, I did another 5 minute time lapse, it drops to 0.12 and slowly goes back up to 0.22. I turn off the AC, open the windows and my door, and the device goes right back up to 0.31 in a matter of minutes. So really not that much of a difference using recirculate mode and outside air, 0.16 for recirculate mode and 0.22 for outside air. Again, I currently have the Xtechnor HEPA filters, the Farmogo inlet filter, and coverlet screen when doing this test. I even went on a drive with this air quality monitor using the outside air, hoping that maybe other vehicle fumes would spike the air reading. Surprisingly, it read about 0.2 for the quick 2 minutes I was filming it. So maybe these third-party filters actually do something. Again, depending on your feedback, I may just reinstall new Tesla stock cabin filters and do another air quality reading in the future. Who knows, it might actually read similar numbers and this could all be overhyped. What do you think? Comment down below. I hope I answered your question regarding the AC smell in your Tesla Model 3. If you found this video helpful, consider subscribing and clicking that like button below for more content like this in the future. Stay safe out there, and I'll see you all on the next one.